punch. Good morning. Would everybody please stand as I lead our school in the Pledge of Allegiance?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, and remember, Crest, together everyone achieves more. Griffin, Juliana, and Lauren sat down to talk with our intern, Miss Carr. Great camera work, Andrew. Roll the tape, please.
We are here with Miss Carr, our class of student teacher here at Crest.
Has being a teacher always been something that you want to do?
Yeah, it's been something that I've been interested in doing since I was in first grade. I had a first year teacher that year, and she was awesome, and I've always wanted to be a teacher ever since.
What college do you go to?
Right now, I go to the University of New England, and that's in Biddeford.
When you found out that you were coming to Miss Bradburn's class, were you nervous?
I was so nervous that I cried. But you guys are awesome, and I already knew you, so I don't know why I was so nervous. But I got over it pretty quickly, and now things are great.
What is Mrs. Bradburn teaching you?
Mostly at the beginning, and I mean even now, I worked on math with her and learning how to do math lessons because it's something that I'm not completely comfortable with. Now I'm a lot more comfortable with it since we've been practicing. But just learning how to teach different types of lessons because you have different approaches, and that's been really what she's been teaching me. And just how to be awesome in general because we all know that Miss Bradburn's awesome. She's awesome.
What do you find easy about teaching?
What I find easiest about teaching is really, well, I think the easiest part is getting to know you guys, because getting to know your personalities is a huge part of teaching, because the more I know you, the more you know me, the better we can work together and everybody can do their jobs and learn tons.
What do you find hard about teaching?
I would say that the hardest part is not being stressed out, trying to keep yourself calm. Because when you don't necessarily have everything planned out, that can be really, really stressful, and you just have to keep your head in game and plan.
What grade do you hope to teach?
I would say anywhere between kindergarten and fourth grade, because I love you guys, and I'm a big fan of first and second grade, but I've never been in kindergarten or third grade, but I'm still interested in what they do there, and those kids are really fun.
What school do you hope to teach at?
I'm not sure yet because I just found out that I'm moving to Las Vegas in September, and hopefully I'll be able to find a job there when I move there.
Thank you for talking with us today, and we hope you do well on the big test.
Thank you, Julia.
Back to you in the studio.
Our fitness reporters this month are Audrey, Evan, and Lillian. Great camera work, Graham. Roll the tape, please.
I'm Audrey, and I'm here with
Lillian
and Evan,
and we're here for the last fitness report of the year.
We're here to tell you the top five fitness safety tips of the summer.
Number five, always watch where you are riding.
Whoa, look at that bird! Whoa!
Four, always wear sunglasses to protect your eyes from the sun's rays.
Try these. Oh, much better.
Number three, always swim with a buddy.
Yay!
That was fun!
Always wear something to protect your feet from the hot sand or tar.
I should have worn my sandals to protect my feet.
And the number one fitness tip is always wear a life jacket on a boat. It could save your life.
Ah, this is a great day to be sailing.
Whoa!
Should have been wearing a life jacket.
That's it from here. Have a safe summer.
Brady, Laura, Roland, and Tyler here to talk about a Horizons fundraiser. Great camera work, Jack. Roll the tape, please.
We are here to tell you about a fundraiser that we are doing in Horizons. We work with Mrs. Freitag, and our project is to do something good for the world and learn something at the same time.
We wanted to help animals. Roland, Tyler, and I have chosen to save endangered animals through the World Wildlife Foundation. The foundation protects populations of endangered animals, including the spotted leopard, barn owl, and Pocendara frog.
I'm raising money for Live and Let Live Farm, which is in Concord, New Hampshire. They rescue abused and unwanted animals, mostly horses, and give them shelter and attention.
Anyone wanting to help by making a donation to either cause can buy label jars in the office lobby.
Thanks for your support.
Back to you in the studio.
Our health beat reporters this month are Katie and Libby. Great camera work, Ethan. Roll the tape, please.
Hi, I'm Libby.
And I'm Katie.
We are your health beat reporters.
This week, we are going to talk about sun safety.
That's right, Katie. We are going to find out how to protect our skin from sun damage.
First, let's see what people know about sun safety.
We are taking our roving camera to ask some staff members and fellow students how they take care of their skin in the sun.
This will be very interesting. Roll the tape, please.
Can we ask you a question for broadcast news?
Sure, Libby.
Do you use any sun protection on your skin?
On my skin, of course I do. I use a 30 sunscreen every single day.
Sir?
Why do you think it's important to protect your skin from the sun?
If you get a sunburn, it can really hurt. It can itch. If you get it really bad.
Hi, do you use any sun protection on your skin?
Yes, I do. I usually use sunscreen before I go to the beach and before I go to like a pool or something.
Why do you think it's important to protect your skin from the sun?
Because if you get a sunburn, it really hurts and it's hard to take or something that I like to do and stuff.
Do you use any sun protection on your skin?
Yes, definitely. When I go to the beach, I put sunscreen. Even when I go in the pool, usually sunscreen.
Why do you think it's important to protect your skin from the sun?
Because so you don't get a sunburn. Yeah, and like use lots of sunscreen so you don't get a sunburn.
Thank you.
That was great. Now we have some very important sun safety facts for you.
So, why do we protect our skin from the sun? First of all, our skin is the largest organ in our body, and it protects everything inside our bodies. And the sun can cause skin cancer, which can be very serious.
That's right, Katie. So we need to take good care of it. We should always use a sunscreen with an SPF of 30 or greater. SPF means sun protection factor. The greater the number, the longer you are protected. So use a 50 instead of a 30.
A hat is always good to use with a visor, like a baseball cap. Always know where to go for shade, like our gazebo in the back playground.
Sunglasses are important to use to protect our eyes also, as they can burn. Keep drinking water to hydrate.
So remember to take care of your skin in the sun. It will thank you later in life with less wrinkles.
That's right, Katie. Who wants wrinkles? This is Libby.
And this is Katie,
signing off for Health Beat. Back to you!
We interrupt this broadcast for the following commercial. Roll the tape, please.
totally optimal.
You can do it.
Thank you. I'm Zach.
And I'm Noah.
And this is your weekend weather report.
It's going to be rainy in the high low 50s.
Saturday is going to be partly cloudy in the mid 50s.
Sunday is going to be the warmest day, but in the afternoon it's going to be rainy.
This weekend it will be rainy, so you should stay inside and play video games.
But on Sunday, you should go to the beach, but not in the afternoon. Go in the morning.
Back to you!
Here are the announcements of birthdays are Danielle and Addie. Over to you, Danielle.
Thank you, Lily. There are no student birthdays to announce today. There are three students celebrating their birthdays this weekend. Nathaniel and Mr. Johnston's class and Katie and Mrs. LeBlanc's class will be celebrating their birthdays Saturday. Erin and Mrs. Marquis's class will be celebrating her birthday on Sunday. There are no staff birthdays. Happy birthday, everyone. Addie?
Next Friday, May 20th, we will be having a spring bike walk to school today. So get your walking shoes on, bikes in shape, and don't forget to wear your helmet. Details will be posted on the Crest website in the flyer section. Coastal Ridge will be saying goodbye to one of our students today. Adele from Mrs. 4th grade class will be moving to France with her family. Au revoir, Adele. We will miss you, but you will know you will enjoy your new school and the great adventures ahead of you. Back to you, Maggie.
For WBN4 News, this concludes our monthly broadcast, brought to you by Ms. Bradburn's class. I'm Maggie.
And I'm Lily.
Signing off for broadcast news.